亲爱的弟兄姐妹早安。
Good morning brothers and sisters.
很开心今天早晨又可以跟大家一起来敬拜。
It is our pleasure just to be able to worship with you all again.
我们的神是信实的，他每一天都要做新事。
Our God is faithful and he wants to do something new every single day.
所以如果你旁边有你的家人，你可以跟他说，神今天要在我们当中做新事。
Right, so go ahead, tell your family members, say God wants to do a new thing in you and through you.
教会的读经进度出埃及记到明天是最后一天。
So if you've been following our scripture reading, tomorrow will be our last day in Exodus.
让我们一起来看明天的经文。
So we're going to take a look at the scriptures today.
出埃及记40章34到38节，这边说
Exodus 40:34-38, it says this.
当时云彩遮盖会幕，耶和华的荣光就充满了帐幕。摩西不能进会幕，因为云彩停在其上，并且耶和华的荣光充满了帐幕。每逢云彩从帐幕收上去，以色列人就启程往前，前往。云彩若收不上去，若不收上去，他们就不启程，直到云彩被收上去。日间耶和华的云彩是在帐幕以上，夜间云中有火，在以色列全家的眼前，在他们所行的路上都是这样。
Now then the cloud covered the tent of meetings, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle. Moses could not enter the tent of meeting because the cloud had settled upon it, and the glory of the Lord filled the tabernacle.In all the travels of the Israelites, whenever the cloud lifted from above the tabernacle, they would set out. But if the cloud did not lift, they did not set out until the day it lifted. So the cloud of the Lord was over the tabernacle by day, and fire was in the cloud by night, in the sight of all the house of Israel during all their travels.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，神的同在，他不是只有当我们主日来敬拜他的时候才会跟我们在一起。
The presence of God is not just when we worship Him,
而是他每一天，当我们来到他面前的时候，神的同在就要充满在我们的当中。
The presence of God is available whenever we come to Him with worship.
所以，让我们一起来祷告。
So we want to pray today.
是主他亲自教导摩西跟以色列人怎么样来建造会幕。
In the same way, how God taught Moses and Israel how to build a tabernacle.
也是主他亲自赐下能够做巧工的智慧跟灵，在那些工匠的里面，以至于他们可以完成会幕。
And we're going to pray that God will also teach us how to welcome His presence.
所以好不好，我们来祷告，就是求主的灵来充满我们，亲自来教导我们如何来建造我们生命的会幕。
So we're going to pray how we can build a temple, our body as a living sacrifice.
好像我们每一天都可以来经历神的同在跟引导。
So we can experience Him on every single day.
让我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray.
主，我感谢你，主，我们赞美你。主，你亲自要来对我们说话，你亲自要来教导我们。主，当我们来到你的面前，主耶稣，当我们把我们自己仰望在你的手中，主，当我们照着你的指示，主来行啊、来造这个会幕的时候，主耶稣，主，你就要把你的同在降下。主耶稣，我赞美你，并且你每一天都要来与我们说话。主耶稣，我感谢你，主，好像也不只是我们与你的关系，而是在我们在你的会幕的里面，当我们听见你的声音，主，你也同样要来教导我们，在我们的家庭，在我们的职场，主啊，在我们手中所要做的一切的事情上面，主，你都要来指教我们。谢谢主，我们赞美你，我们感谢你，主啊，就愿你亲自的主啊，帮助我们可以分别出我们生命当中的一些时间。主耶稣，我们如同摩西一样，主，我们就是来到你的面前来寻求你的面。主，你的云柱火柱不离开我们，你的引导也不离开我们。谢谢耶稣，我们赞美你，我们赞美你。接下来我们来祷告，我相信当我们用我们的心灵跟诚实来敬拜的时候，主他信实的荣耀就要充满在我们的当中。
And next we're going to pray that as we worship Him, that God's presence will continue to fill us.
我们求主圣灵这时候来充满我，来充满我们的家人跟每一位教会的弟兄姐妹。
We We're going to pray that the Holy Spirit come and fill every single one of us.
我们一起来祷告。主耶稣，我们感谢你，你是信实的神。主耶稣，当我们用我们的心灵跟诚实来敬拜你，来到你面前的时候，主耶稣，我们两三个人奉你的名聚集，你就与我们同在。主，我们感谢你，谢谢耶稣。主啊，求你把一个渴慕加添在我们的当中。今天我们要来听见你的声音，主，今天我们也要来明白你的引导。主，就求你将你自己生命的道来指教我们。主，我们要行走在其上来得着丰盛的生命。谢谢耶稣，赞美你。谢谢主，你要来启示我们，你是一位乐意启示你自己的神。因此主啊，我们就是来到你的面前，主啊，我们来聆听你的话语。主，我赞美你，谢谢耶稣，赞美神。接下来我们向我们的神来献上我们的感谢跟赞美。
And next we're going to offer our praise and worship to God.
他是信实，满有怜悯，不轻易发怒，有慈爱，圣洁荣耀的主。
He is faithful, graceful, and merciful, and slow to anger, and rich in love.
他是满有全能的神，在他没有难成的事。
And he's a powerful God.
他也是那一位为我们死在十字架上，赎回我们，来得着全新生命，能够来敬拜他的神。
And he's our God that died for our sins so that we can have a new life.
所以今天靠着主耶稣基督，我们可以坦然无惧地来到他施恩的宝座前。
So today we can come boldly before him with no fear.
好不好，这时候就让我们花一点时间，我们来数算他的恩典，向他来献上我们的赞美。
So right now we're just going to come, we're going to ask right now that we will count the blessing that he has given us.
亲爱的主，我们赞美你。主，谢谢你是信实的神，你是有恩典的神，有怜悯的主。主，你不轻易发怒，有丰盛的慈爱跟诚实。主，我赞美你，你是圣洁的主，圣洁掌权坐在宝座上荣耀的王。我们向你献上我们的赞美。主啊，在你没有难成的事。主，我们赞美你，因为你已经胜过坟墓，你胜过死亡。主，我们靠着你得胜，也得着这全新的生命。谢谢耶稣，你今天要在我们的生命当中来做一件新事。主，你是能够在旷野开道路，在沙漠开江河的神。谢谢耶稣，我们欢迎主圣灵，主啊，来引导我们。我们赞美你，愿今天我们的敬拜，主啊，我们的祷告，主，今天我们整个的主日，主啊，主啊，来荣耀你的名。谢谢耶稣，赞美神，听我们的祷告，是奉靠主耶稣基督的名， Amen。主，全能的神，你是与我们同在的主。
God, you're the Almighty, and you are the God who is always with us.
你不撇下我们，你与我们同行。
And you are the one who desires to walk with us.
所以我们不会灭亡或惧怕，因为我们要来跟随你。
So we will follow you with no fear.
一起来敬拜他。
God, we praise you, you're the God Almighty.
你是与我们同在，不撇弃我们，并且要领我们前行的主。
Yeah, you're the God who never leaves us or forsakes us.
主，你是良善的父。
God, you are the gracious Daddy.
所以我们相信你一切的带领，即便我们还不知道未来要发生什么事，但是主，我们相信你。
So God, we trust in your leading, even though we don't know where we're going.
Thousand storms. Oh, and I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you'reAnd that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Love is so undeniable.
耶稣，你的爱是超过我们所求所想。
There are times when we just bask in your presence.
所以我们今天要浸透在你的同在里面。
The way Moses did.
就像摩西一样。
Because there is no more curtain between us and you.
因为我们关系当中没有任何的帕子。
There is no curtain between us and you in our homes.
所以我们也相信我们的家与你也没有任何的隔离。
May the presence of the Lord rest upon every person in every home, Lord.
所以我祷告，让我你的灵降临在每一个人的家里里面。
Love so undeniable, I can hardly speak.Unexplainable, I can hardly think as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still as you call me, deeper still into love, every single person watching.
父神，我为每一个人现在在看直播祷告。
God, as we live our lives, there are many things that people say about us.
我们现在可能在我们周边当中有很多不同的声音。
They will tell us what they think about us.
他们可能在批评我们。
It may be good or bad.
但这些话也说，有些是好，有些是坏的。
But God, help us.Our identity is founded in you.
主啊，但是我们相信我们的身份是从你而来。
For the praises of man, I will never stand.
因为我们不是靠其他人的夸奖。
But for the praises of the Lord.
但是呢，我们要把我们敬拜献上给你。
Thank you, Lord.
谢谢耶稣。
恩典何等的爱，你大能手扶持我，太荣美，何等荣美，我愿降服高举你名，耶稣，你的荣耀我所边上能医治，神的儿子彰显恩典真实，何等的爱带我进入你恩赐，真美好，何等今天当我们敬拜你，愿你荣耀的云彩就降临在我们的当中。
God, as we worship you today, let your presence just be filled in our homes.
主，我们需要你，我们渴慕你。
God, we need you and we want you.
此时此地，愿你升起你的荣耀，就在。 充满我，使我自由。
弟兄姐妹，让我们都闭起我们的眼睛，有一点时间我们安静在神的同在的里面。
Let's close our eyes right now and just come quietly before the presence.
让我们来纪念神，他曾经在我们生命当中所说过的话，所做过的事。
And let us reflect and meditate on the things that God has spoken to us and done for us.
来思想他的良善，来思想他的信实。
Let's think of God's goodness and His faithfulness.
是的，我们要向你献上我们的感谢。
So God, we want to lift and want to offer you our praise and thanksgiving.
谢谢你拣选我们，谢谢你赎回我们，也谢谢主，你乐意做我们永远的父。
Thank you for choosing us and become our Father.
谢谢主，你在我们生命里面所说过的每一句话语。
Thank you for everything that you have spoken over us.
谢谢主，我们是有倚靠的。
Thank you that we can lean on you.
我们是有盼望的，我们是有未来的。
Thank you, we have hope through you.
因为我们的盼望未来不在于这个世界所告诉我们的，乃是在于你自己的话语。
Thank you, our hope comes from you.
而你的话语立定在天，天地都废去的时候，你的话语一点一话都不会改变。
And thank you for your word. Everything shall pass, but your word shall stand.
所以主，我们今天就是单单来献上我们的赞美跟感谢。
So we want to lift up our praise and worship.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，让我们持续带着一个感恩的心。
So let's continue to worship Him with a heart of thanksgiving.
让我们来问问神，当我们接下来要奉献的时候，我们求主圣灵来告诉我们要怎么样的来奉献。
And as we go into a time of offering, let the Holy Spirit speak to you personally.
让我们今天的奉献是一个在信心里面的奉献。
And let our offering be an act of faith.
好像不是一个习惯，好像也不是出于 OK 主这样子告诉我，我就要这样子做，而是让我们今天来聆听主的声音，在爱跟信心的里面，我们来献上我们的金钱。
So today, as we give an offering, let us not be obligated, but let us do it out of love.
愿我们今天所献上的讨主的喜悦。
And may our sacrifice and offering be pleasing to God.
所以弟兄姐妹，你会在荧幕上面看到一个奉献的一个信息，就是我们现在是用透过线上来奉献。
So right now you will see on the screen an information on how you can give online.
你可以拍下照片来记得这个账号，或者是说在教会的电子周报上面也会有奉献账号的信息。
So you may take a picture or you can also refer to the digital bulletin.
然后鼓励大家，如果神有把一个感动放在你的里面的话，不要就是等一下就忘记了，而是就是等一下聚会结束以后就记得照着你的感动来做奉献。
So give according to what God has put in your heart.
然后如果你是第一次奉献，也请你扫接下来的 QR code 可以来回报你的奉献相关的资讯，方便我们知道谁奉献了，跟我们可以寄奉献收据给你。
And if this is your first time in our church, if this is your first time watching, first time giving, we ask that you scan the QR code and fill out that information so we can give you a tax receipt.
感谢主，我们的神真是美好。
God, we thank you because you are amazing.
我们的神真美好，是吗？
Do you all agree?
那就让你转向你的家人，跟他说，我们的神真是美好。
So go ahead, turn to the family members and say, God is good.
然后也让我们来听，今天的消息报告，跟等一下 Pastor Chen 所要分享的信息。
And now here's our announcements and also the sermon.
愿神祝福大家。
Have a great Sunday.
Hi, 的弟兄姐妹平安。
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
如果今天是您第一次线上收看我们的主日崇拜，真的非常的欢迎您。如果您想要更多认识德胜灵粮堂，或是希望有人能够为您祷告，欢迎您扫荧幕上的 QR code 或点选脸书内文的连结，留下您的联络方式和代祷事项，我们会跟您联络，并且来为您祷告。
If this is your first time tuning in online and would like to get to know us more as a church,We invite you to scan the QR code that you see or leave a comment in our Facebook. We would like to pray for you and get to know you better.
感谢神，我们的 LINE app 正式上线咯。未来您不止
可以透过 LINE APP 收到教会的最新消息，还可以进行线上的奉献、缴费、课程的报名，非常的方便。如果您还没有加入，也欢迎您点选荧幕上的 QR Code 加入。在您加入之后，也请记得要点选注册，然后来填写您的基本资料，才能够开通您的账号哦。
We're excited to announce that our official account is live and online, and you can use this LINE app to receive the most updated news about our church. And you can do your online tithing, any payments and any registrations on this account. It's very convenient. So if you haven't already, please go ahead and just scan the QR code and click on sign in, and then we can activate your account.
下个礼拜天主日会后是我们本月的祷告会，在这个时刻，让我们一起透过同心合一的祷告来带出影响力。时间是下个礼拜天的主日，7月25号的会后，11:45到12:15，欢迎大家一起来参加。
Our next prayer meeting will be after church on July 25th from 11:45 to 12:15. We want to invite you to join us together and pray and make an impact at this time.
大家是否有参加这个礼拜五的安息与相遇敬拜之夜呢？感谢主在这个聚会里面做了很多奇妙的工作。在7月30号的礼拜五晚上，同样是8:00到8:45，我们还有一次的安息跟相遇的敬拜之夜。欢迎大家一起透过更深的敬拜来与神相遇，领受神所要赐给我们的安息跟平安。聚会当中有医治祷告的服事，也欢迎您可以邀请您的慕道朋友一起来参加，一起经历神的爱。
So last Friday, we held our online worship night, and we saw God did wondrous works. And the next Friday online Sabbath and Encounter worship night will be on July 30th from 8 p.m. to 8:45 p.m.We want to invite you to go deeper with us in worship and listen to the voice of God and encounter Him and receive His rest and peace. There will be prayer ministry afterwards, and we will do some healing. And we want to invite you to invite others to join.
爱就要有行动，让我们一起用我们的爱来建造神的家。所以，如果你对影片拍摄、影片剪辑、平面设计、PPT 制作、音控或者是文字翻译、撰写文字稿、做主日信息摘要、经营 LINE APP、Facebook 这些社群软体有专业，或者是您有兴趣来学习，我们非常欢迎您加入我们服事团队的行列。让我们一起让家伟大，用行动来回应神，相信您会经历一个提升跟神迹。
We want to invite you to love in action. And for us, we need you. If you have experience in graphic design and filmmaking, editing, doing PowerPoint presentations, translations, summarizing sermons, and even managing social media accounts. If you have any of these experiences, we want to invite you to just respond with action, and we can experience more of God through serving together.
爱也可以透过捐款来帮助有需要的人。在这样疫情的时刻里面，其实有一群人是非常需要被帮助的，就是在街上的游民。 Saw Ministry 中华岩石国际爱蔓延协会，也就是去年圣诞节我们有送礼物给小朋友的那个单位，这时候他们也在帮助一些街上有需要的游民，把疫情当中他们需要的资源物资来提供给他们。所以如果你有感动或负担，欢迎您来奉献给这个单位，或者是您也可以奉献给其他你有负担的机构。在这样子的一个时刻，让我们透过捐款来帮助有需要的人。
We would also like to invite you to love on those in need. And for us, we have partnered with the Salt Ministry, who are really huge and involved in helping the homeless people. And last year we worked with themDuring Christmas time when we help send free gifts to children. And this year, we want to help these homeless people with sending some resources and maybe care packages in this COVID environment. So if you would like to, you can go ahead and donate your financial resources to the Salt Ministry.
以上就是今天的消息报告，那也祝大家可以享受等一下的主日信息来听见什么声音。
And these are our announcements for this week. We hope that you will be blessed by the sermon.
Hi, Victory Church. My name is Frank.
Hi, 德胜灵粮堂的弟兄姐妹，大家好，我是 Frank.
And I'm here to share about how God has worked to provide for my family in the last few months.
所以今天我想要分享的是，神在过去这几个月是怎么来供应我的家庭。
So in September of 2020, my wife and I both felt compelled to obey God and enter full-time education.
所以在2020年的9月呢，我的太太跟我同时都有受到感动，然后就是我们要去当全职的学生。
And this meant that I would resign from my full-time job and we would move to a smaller place and we would live off of the student stipend that my wife got through her PhD program.
所以这就代表的是说、我们要辞掉我们当时的工作，然后换到一个比较小的房子，然后我们可能就要靠着我太太的奖学金，博士班的奖学金来维持我们的生计。
We decided that we will focus on just our savings and narrowing our month-to-month expenditures, and with that, this will be able to prepare for the future by focusing on studying.
所以、那时候我们有算过就是我们的一些储蓄，然后我们如果 每个月都很小心的开支的话，这应该可以帮助我们就是维持到这整个学业结束。
So this was a step of faith that we took, but little did we know that God was calling us into waters that were of deeper faith at the time.
所以对我们来说，这真的是靠出信心跨出的那一步。但是我们不知道的是，神其实在邀请我们进入更深的一个信心里面。
Just a couple of months after, around December, we found out that Mariah, my wife, was pregnant.
所以、在2020年12月的时候，我们就发现、我太太怀孕了。
And there was a lot of discomfort for her. She was going through a lot of morning sickness.There was a lot of demands because of life, and we were navigating a lot of unknowns.
对，所以、我太太怀孕之后，其实身体就不是那么舒服，然后刚开始有很多的、孕吐。对，那我们同时间也在、适应生活中很多的一个变化。
But we believe that God can be found in the unknown and the mysterious seasons.
但是我们也相信说，在充满未知跟这个很多神秘事情的季节里面呢，我们都可以找到神。
In the last year, we have found God opened the provision, storehouses of heaven for us in many, many ways.
所以、在过去的半年呢，我们就发现说、神其实有、安排了一个住所，然后来供应我们的生活。
We were able to connect with community of believers. We were able to restore relationships within our family, and we were also provided for materially in ways that we just didn't expect.
嗯，所以在这个地方呢，我们其实可以跟很多的基督徒的弟兄姐妹一起连结。我们在其中，我们也重拾了跟我们家人的一个关系，然后我们也被神也有供应我们所需的。
We entered a season of abundance despite tension from external realities.
虽然说在、外在的这个现实里面带给我们很多的压力，但是我们觉得我们进入了一个丰盛的季节。
So for the first couple of months of Mariah's pregnancy, she had to commute to Dongli from Nangang, where we live, because that's where one of her labs is located. And she had to take the local train, and itAmounted to a four-hour commute that was very tiring for her. And as a pregnant woman, you can imagine that being very difficult.
对，所以、在 Mariah 刚怀孕的前几个月，其实她非常辛苦，因为她每天必须要、坐火车从南港到、中立去上班，然后、去她的这个实验室。那时候再加上她身体不舒服，所以这个对她来说是一个很每天很艰辛的一件事情。
But on March 13th, one evening after coming back from one of her long commutes, one of our friends showed up at the doorstep of our house in the first floor.
所以、每一天就是 Mariah 都要来回花四个小时的时间在通勤。那有一天当她、很长的通勤回到家以后，那个三月十三号的时候、突然之间就有一个朋友的朋友就出现在我们家的门口。
And she told us, hey, I have a gift for you. And Mariah immediately thought, is it a puppy?
然后那时候那个朋友出现的时候就说，诶，我有一个礼物要送给你哦。然后 Mariah 第一个反应就说，诶，你是要送我一只小狗吗？
It was bigger than a puppy.
那但是后来发现这个礼物其实是比一只小狗来的大得多。
It was actually a white Nissan, a car that she gave us that was wrapped in a lot of decorations and ribbons. As it was a gift for us, and they gave us the keys.
对，所以后来发现说，这个朋友要送我们的礼物其实是一个白色的尼桑的车子，然后他还把它整个包装起来，然后用这个整个装饰的很好，要送给我们当一个礼物。
And it was just a gift that we've never, a kind of gift that we've never received before, and it gave us such a blessing at the time, and even until today, because as you know, the pandemic created a lockdown where if we wanted to go to the hospital, for example.During this time, it would have been very dangerous for Mariah and very exhausting. But now we're able to take the car and drive to the hospital much more safely.
嗯，然后这个礼物呢，其实对我们来说是一个非常非常大的一个祝福，因为在疫情开始之后，其实我们要去医院回诊什么之间都非常的不方便，尤其是当 Mariah 在怀孕，然后在现在疫情的期间，如果要乘坐大众交通工具，其实是不太方便也不太安全，但是这辆车可以帮助我们很顺利的每次都去回诊。
And just to talk a little bit more about this friend. She's a Taiwanese that's 42 years old. She had recently been married and she's a first generation Christian. And she told us that she was praying about this and she felt that God was telling her this car is for us. She had the option to sell the car, but decided instead to give it to us. And we found out later on that at the age of 42, she got pregnant and she's currently past her first trimester and she's expecting a baby very soon.
对，所以我要来讲一下这个送给我们车子的这个朋友。其实她是一个台湾人，一个女士，然后她42岁，所以那时候她其实是有这个，她有一个选择，她可以把这个车送给我们，但是其实她同时间也可以把这个车卖掉。但是她在祷告之中，她就有感动要把这个车子卖给要把这个车子送给我们。然后后来呢，我们也发现说，这个女士虽然42岁，那因为她刚结婚，所以她其实也怀孕了，然后就是刚刚过了前面3个月，然后现在正在也是期待宝宝的诞生这样。
And since then, we've been able to receive many other gifts and donations from friends and family for a baby, from baby clothes, maternity clothes for Mariah as well.And somebody also gifted us a crib. And at the same time, on that same day, somebody also gave us another crib. So we have two cribs, one for Mariah's parents' house and one for our house as well.
对，然后从那个之后呢，其实我们就一直接受到很多人给我们的礼物或者是捐献，那包括宝宝的衣服，或者是包括 Mariah 的孕妇装，然后甚至婴儿床都有人送给我们，那甚至我们还拿到了有人送我们2张婴儿床，所以现在我们有一张婴儿床可以放在家里，另外一张我们可以放在 Mariah 的娘家。
And that is a testimony I wanted to share with you from my family.It is my hope that, this is something that touches people of the church, and that they can see that God is working alongside us, regardless of the situation, and that he's entrusting us with many things and giving and providing when we need.
嗯，所以这是一个就是关于我们家庭的最近的这个很大的一个见证。那我也希望透过这个我们家庭的这个见证呢，可以触碰到大家的心，然后真的是可以看到说神其实在我们的生活中、生命中都是一直在做工，然后我们必须要更加的来信靠神，然后他会持续的来供应我们的生活。
So it's my hope that this testimony does the same or even more and create more abundance in your life. And thank you very much for listening.
所以我也希望这个见证可以成为一个起点，然后神在你们每个人的生命之中都可以做更多的事，然后带来更大的丰盛。所以谢谢今天大家的聆听。
And this is Katie over here translating, so thank you very much, Katie.
好，然后我是 Katie 今天的翻译，谢谢。
OK， 拜拜。
Good morning, Church.
大家早上好。
Today, I want to talk to you guys about while we wait.
今天我想要讲的主题就是在我们等待的时候。
So in the next couple of weeks, we'll be reading over the First and Second Chronicles.
所以在接下来的几周呢，我们会开始念历代志上跟下。
But today, I want to talk about Ezra a little bit more.
但是今天呢，我想要先来讲一下以斯拉记。
For the last 2 months, our country has been on a lockdown, and now it's slowly opening up.
对，所以在过去两个月呢，我们的国家就是在一个三级警戒的一个状态。那接下来在慢慢几周，我们就会看到逐步的一个解封。
You know, lives have been lost, jobs have been lost, and people are in despair. But finally, there are things that is turning around for us.
对，在过去的这个几周呢，我们看到有些人可能失去了生命，有些人失去了工作，但是慢慢的我们看到事情逐渐的一步一步的恢复。
You know, the Bible has an answer is relevant even today.
所以圣经其实也有它给了很多答案，包括我们今天的处境，其实圣经也是给了个答案。
And the reason why I want us to go deeper in the First and Second Chronicles in the next couple weeks is becauseI believe the book was written for a time like this.
所以为什么接下来的几周我们会花比较多的时间来讲历代志，就是因为我相信圣经其实用这两本书在我们现在的处境其实是给了一些答案。
Because the book of Chronicles is a book of recovery.
因为历代志的故事呢，其实就是一个逐步恢复的一个故事。
You know, it's 606 BC, the Israelites were exiled to Babylonia.
所以在西元前606年呢，这个以色列人呢，他们就是被放逐到巴比伦地区。
The Babylonians that surrounded Jerusalem, they tore down the walls and took everybody in captivity, and the Israelites had to live in refugee camps for about 70 years.
所以那时候呢，巴比伦人就占领了耶路撒冷，他把这些城墙都拆毁了，然后把所有人都俘虏过去。所以这些以色列人呢，就是损失了他们的家产，所有的东西，然后在接下来的70年，他们就是活在像一个难民营的状况一样。
And that's probably how some of us feel for the last 2 months.
所以这可能对我们部分人来说，就像我们过去两个月活的处境一样。
I know I felt like a captivity to my own home, you know, to my own family, because I couldn't go out.
然后我自己都感觉因为我不能外出，所以有时候我会觉得我好像被囚禁在家里一样。
However, I believe God is doing something amazing starting at this very moment.
但是我相信神在现在的时候其实正在做一些伟大的事。
See, God used a Persian king named Cyrus to conquer the Babylonians, and then in return, they also allowed the Israelites to go back to their homeland to worship.
所以神呢，在当时就用了一个波西国王叫古列，那也有些译本是把他叫做塞鲁士。他用这个波西的这个国王呢，去占领了巴比伦地区，然后接着这个国王呢，就让这些以色列人可以开放他们回到原来的住处。
In 536 BC, the Israelites finally are able to return home along with the possession and the children.
所以在史前536年呢，这些以色列人呢就回到了他们原本的居住的地方，然后带着他们的家产还有孩子回到故乡。
They actually had to walk roughly about 800 miles in order to get to the destination.
所以在回到家之前，其实他们必须要长途跋涉大概800英里的距离。
Now let me ask you this, if you were in captivity for the last 70 years, if you had lost everything, and because of your own mistake,If you can get a second chance, what would you do?
所以让我来问你一个问题，假设说你曾经有过经验是因为你的错误，所以导致你自己被囚禁，然后损失了所有东西，那如果今天你再有重新来过一次的机会的话，你要怎么做呢？
And that's why the book of Chronicles is so relevant and so important.
所以这是为什么历代志呢？对我们来说其实是非常贴切的一个故事。
Because at that time, God sent two spirit-filled leaders to boost the morale of the Israelites.
因为那时候神呢就派遣了两个非常被圣灵充满的领袖来鼓励并且来带领这些以色列人。
One is Nehemiah and the other one is Ezra.
一个就是尼希米，一个是以斯拉。
See, Nehemiah, he was a cupbearer, but he was the person who built the wall in order so there is safety around the Jerusalem city.
所以尼希米呢，其实就是当时带领这些以色列人重新把耶路撒冷的城墙筑起来，所以让他们可以重获安全。
But just because you have a physical wall, it does not mean that you have learned your lesson. See, that's why God also sent Ezra to boost up the morale to give the people hope for a time like that.
但是仅仅只是把城墙造起来，不代表这些以色列人就会真的有一个对的心态。所以呢，神就又派了以斯拉来带领这些以色列人重新来建造他们的品性跟心。
See, even though Ezra, he didn't build the walls, but he built the hearts of the people. He gave them hope. He reminded them who they were.
所以以斯拉呢，他不是来建造这个城墙，但是他重新来建造人的心，让这些以色列人呢可以重新有希望。
See, the Israelites, they were returning to a place where their grandfathers or even their ancestors had flourished, but their fathers had failed.
所以这些以色列人当初回到耶路撒冷的时候，其实耶路撒冷是在他们的祖父那一辈是一个非常繁盛的地方，但是在他们的父亲这一辈呢，就整个毁坏掉了。
And maybe this is how some of us feel. Maybe we feel that, you know, in Taiwan, our grandfathers or our ancestors have flourished, but right now the situation for us is really, really tough.
所以可能我们身在台湾，有些人会有这种感觉，就是台湾以前在我们祖父那一辈感觉是非常繁盛非常繁荣的，但是到现在好像境况就没有像以前来的那么好，然后是非常挑战的。
See, God removed the people from the land in order to teach them a lesson, but at the same time, in the book of Chronicles, now God is bringing them back so they can put the lesson into practice.
所以神当时呢把这些以色列人带离耶路撒冷，其实为了是教导他们一些课题，但是在历代志呢，神就把他们带回来，然后让他们可以把这些学到的课题真的是应用在生活上面。
During the last year or so, the whole globally we have been on a lockup and everybody has been, you know, put like the momentum has stopped, but now people are restarting their lives.
所以在过去的一年呢，其实全球因为疫情感觉好像停摆了，但是现在好像逐步逐步开始大家的生活又重新逐步的恢复。
And I do feel that we can definitely learn from the book of Chronicles, but because as we are starting back, I also believe there are lessons that perhaps God want us to learn.
所以我相信其实来这时候来研读历代志是对我们是很有帮助的，因为可以让从那里面我们可以看到神希望我们学习到的事情。
If we learn these lessons from the book of from the Bible, I believe we will recover faster and better, and with the ability to help others and get the country rebooted.
所以如果呢，我们可以把我们从圣经上面学到的这些课题真的是应用出来，我们应该可以更快的来恢复我们的自己，甚至我们可以来帮助其他人更快的恢复。
Now to understand our journey to these couple of weeks, we need to start at the end of the story.
所以如果我们要来看一下我们过去学到了什么，那其实我们应该是从这个故事的最后头来看。
See, all the lessons learned are flashback lessons. We rarely know what we are learning while we are in the middle of it. However, in the book of Chronicles, in order to understand, luckily we can read it from the last chapter.
所以很多时候我们都是要事后回头看，我们才会知道我们学到的课题，因为在我们在经历这些事情的时候，其实我们并不知道我们是在学习。所以如果今天我们从历代志来看的话，很幸运的我们可以是直接跳到历代志的最后一章来看到底整件事情发生了什么。
So we're going to look at the last chapter, so if you can turn to 2 Chronicles chapter 36.
所以让我们来看一下历代志下第36章。
Now this is describing the 400 years of choices made by the people of Israel.
所以这一段章节呢，其实是在讲说，在过去400年，这个以色列的人民到底做出了什么样子的选择。
I've been reading from Second Chronicles chapter 36, from 15 to 21.
所以让我们先来念历代志下第36章15到21节。
But the Lord God of their ancestors sent word against them by the hand of them, his messengers, sending them time and time again, for he had compassion on his people and on his dwelling place. But they kept ridiculing God's messengers, despising his word and scoffing at his prophets, until the Lord's wrath was so stirred up against his people that there was no remedy. So he brought up against them the king of Chaldeans, who killed the fit young men with the sword in the house of the sanctuary. He had no pity on a young man or young woman, elderly or aged. He handed them all over them. He took everything to Babylon, all the articles of God's temple, large and small, the treasures of the Lord's temple, and the treasures of the king and his officials. Then the Chaldeans burned God's temple. They tore down Jerusalem's wall, burned all its places, and destroyed all its valuable articles. He deported them who escaped from the sword of the Babylon, and they became servants to him and his sons until the rise of Persian kingdom. This fulfilled the word of the Lord to Jeremiah, and the land enjoyed its Sabbath rest all the days of desolation until 70 years were fulfilled.
所以历代志下第36章15到21节。耶和华他们列祖的神，因为爱惜自己的名和他的居所，从早起来差遣使者去警戒他们，他们却讥笑神的使者，藐视他的言语，讥笑他的先知，以致耶和华的愤怒向他的百姓发作，无法可救。所以耶和华使加勒底人的王来攻击他们，在他们圣殿里用刀杀了他们的壮丁，不怜悯他们的少男处女、老人白首。耶和华将他们都交在加勒底王手里。加勒底王将神殿里的大小器皿和耶和华殿里的财宝，并王和众首领的财宝都带到巴比伦去了。加勒底人焚烧神的殿，拆毁耶路撒冷的城墙，用火烧了城里的宫殿，毁坏了城里宝贵的器皿。凡脱离刀剑的，加勒底王都掳到巴比伦去，做他和他子孙的仆婢，直到波斯国兴起来。这就应验耶和华借耶利米口所说的话，地享受安息，因为地土荒凉便守安息，只满了七十年。
See, with God there's always an until.
所以对神来说永远都会有直到这件事情发生。
Just like it says in verse 20, until the Persian kingdom has arisen.
所以就像第21节里面讲的，就是20节讲的，直到波斯国兴起来。
And there's a reason why God is restarting everything.
所以为什么神把所有东西重新复兴起来是有一个原因的。
And if you have been reading with us in the devotionals living life, it talks about Exodus, how we need to observe the Sabbath.
所以在我们读到活泼的生命里面，其实就有讲到我们要怎么在安息日我们在安息日里面要做什么。
And I believe that this is one of the important lessons that God wants us to learn, is not necessarily to strive, but also by more in working out of Sabbath, from Sabbath.
所以我想这也是神想要我们学习的一点，就是很多时候我们不是要一直去努力，而是我们应该要从神的安息里面来做一些事情。
So with the Israelites, so one of the first thing they need to do as they were rebooting is they need to remember where they had came from.
所以在这些以色列人要重新开始他们的生活之前，第一个他们要学习的课题就是记得他们是从哪里来的。
Now the book of Chronicles is a selected history of the nation of Israel. It leads out the story of David's sin with Bathsheba and also the rebellion of David's children. It leaves out the stories of the wicked kings who worship other gods.
所以历代志里面呢，其实是把这个以色列的这个历史其实是有选择性的摘录下来，在里面呢，其实他并没有提到，比如说大卫王跟八十八的这一个犯下的罪，也没有讲到他孩子的悖逆，他甚至把一些就是崇拜其他神的这些王的故事，其实都没有在历代志里面写出来。
However, in the book of Ezra, it tells us about the good stories.
那但是在以斯拉记里面，其实他告诉我们的是好的故事。
Because remember, Ezra was a builder of people's hearts. He tried to give them hope.
因为我们刚刚有提到，其实以斯拉其实是为了要建造人们的心，然后让人有希望。
Ezra wants to build the pride and self-esteem for the Israelites. So when they reboot the country, they can take pride and ownership of what they're doing.
所以其实以斯拉的目的是想要重建这些以色列人他们的自尊跟自豪，所以当他们有希望的时候，他们可以带着希望来重建这个国家。
And at the same time, the number two lesson is we want to repeat the good and omit the bad.
那第二个他们学到的课题就是我们其实要重复好的事情，但是摒除这些坏的事情。
I'm sure none of us want to do the wrong things over and over again.
我想我们大家都不愿意把这些坏的或不好的事情不停的重复去做。
Now, I do believe that, you know, this is not a... Probably for some of us, it takes the same mistakes, we need to make the same mistakes over and over until we hit the wall and bleed, and then we finally learn.
可能对我们有些人来讲，我们个性就是我们会一直不断的去犯同样的错误，然后一直到我们撞到那个墙，然后撞得头破血流以后，我们可能才会知道要停下来。
This is called a rude awakening.
所以这个也就是苏醒的一刹那。
In 2 Chronicles 36, 22-23 it says this.
所以在历代志下记第36章22-23节这么说。
In the first year the kingCyrus of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord has spoken through Jeremiah, the Lord roused the spirit of King Cyrus of Persia to issue a proclamation throughout his entire kingdom, to put it into writing. This is what the King Cyrus of Persia says. The Lord God of heavens has given me all the kingdoms of the earth and has appointed me to build him a temple at Jerusalem in Judah. Any of his people among you may go up.And may the Lord his God be with him.
所以历代志下第36章22-23节这么说，波斯王古列元年，耶和华为要应验借耶利米口所说的话，就激动波斯王古列的心，使他下诏通告全国说，波斯王古列如此说，耶和华天上的神已将天下万国赐给我，又嘱咐我在犹大的耶路撒冷为他建造殿宇，你们中间凡做他子民的可以上去，愿耶和华他的神与他同在。
So before the fall of Jerusalem, God made his people a promise that someday they will return and they will rebuild.
所以在耶路撒冷毁灭之前，其实神对他的子民做了一个应许，这个应许就是说未来在有一天他们会回到耶路撒冷并且重建。
And what Ezra is teaching us in the final verse is to rely on God's promise.
所以以斯拉在这个最后一节的经文里面在教导我们的事情，就是我们要依靠上帝的应许。
You know, God has promised us never to leave us or forsake us. So whenever we feel forsaken, we simply need to stand firm in God's promise.
所以应许了说他永远不会离开我们，也不会背弃我们。所以如果今天当我们感觉被背弃的时候，我们应该要重新来记起神的这个应许。
And now that we know how it ends, let's look at how it begins.
所以我们刚刚在看完这整个故事的结尾以后，现在我们来从头看这个故事是怎么开始的。
You know, Ezra, he begins by tracing the nation's genealogy.
所以以斯拉呢，其实就第一步就是先开始重新看这个国家的家谱是什么。
He began with Adam, Abraham, and Isaac.
所以他整个的家谱就从亚当、亚伯拉罕跟Isaac 开始。
He tells about the Israel and Judah, and he lists out all the leaders and fathers and tribes.
所以在以斯拉刚开始呢，他就讲了以色列跟犹大的历史，然后呢，他就把所有各族的领袖跟先祖全部都列示下来。
The reason why he wrote this is because so when the people are reading it, they can say, yeah, these are my people, these are my ancestors.
为什么他要这么做呢？就是让这些在读这本书的这些子民看到的时候，会产生认同感，说，哦，这就是我的先祖，这就是我的族人。
And he did it for 10 chapters until chapter 11.When he started to talk about the life of David.
所以在以斯拉记前面十章呢，其实就是在讲这些家族家谱的一些历史。那一直到第十一章，他就开始讲述大卫的一些事迹。
Now the story in the book of Chronicles about the life of David, it does not talk about David's wedding.
所以在这个第十一章开始呢，他就是在讲到大卫等待的故事。
But and this is something that's why this is something that I want to focus more on today.
所以这也就是我们今天想要着重的一个部分。
I believe that in the same way that David waited for his promise to come, is relevant to us right here, right now, as we are waiting for the country to reboot.
所以当时呢，大卫在等待的这个过程还有他的这个经验，其实对我们今天在等待我们国家解除封锁的这个感觉其实是很类似的，而且我相信可以从里面我们可以学到一些课题。
You know, there is a saying that all good things in life are worth waiting for.
所以有一句谚语就是说生命中所有发生的好事都是值得等待的。
But the journey is usually tough because we need to a lot of times walk by faith and walk blindly or just simply trusting.
但是这个旅程呢，可能是很有挑战性的，因为在我们等待的时候，我们可能就是要等待，并且我们要持续我们的信心。
And I believe that today God wants to speak to us that as we while we wait for Him to restart our country, to put us into our destiny, there are lessons that He wants us to learn.
所以今天在我们等待就是神重新开启我们的国家，然后开始重新我们的生活的时候，我相信神也是有一些课题想要我们学习的。
See, there was a promise that was given to David that he's going to be a king.
所以在当时呢，其实神是有给大卫一个应许，说他会成为一个国王。
And that day finally came in 1 Chronicles chapter 10 verse 13 to 14.
然后这一天呢，是在历代志上记第十章第十三到十四节里面才发生的。
It says that Saul died for his unfaithfulness to the Lord because he did not keep the Lord's word. He even consulted a medium for guidance, but he did not inquire of the Lord. So the Lord put him to death and turned the kingdom over to David, the son of Jesse.
所以在历代志上第十章十三到十四节这么说。这样扫罗死了，因为他干犯耶和华，没有遵守耶和华的命，又因他求问交鬼的妇人，没有求问耶和华，所以耶和华使他被杀，把国归于耶西的儿子大卫。
See, the day finally came when Saul had died.
所以这边就讲说终于到了扫罗死了那一天。
And then God finally turned the kingdom over to David.
然后神终于把国归于耶西的儿子大卫。
But during this span of time, it was actually more than the meets the eye. It was actually much longer than we thought.
对，但是中间这个大卫等待的时间呢，其实是长于我们所想象的。
See, at 10 years old, the prophet Samuel came to David's house and anointed him as the king of Israel.
所以在大卫十岁的时候，其实先知撒母耳就来到他们的家，并且高抹这个大卫，说他会成为以色列的王。
And once he was anointed, he did not become a king.
但是当他被高抹以后，其实他并没有马上成为一个王。
In fact, he waited for 5 years until he became the armor bearer for King Saul.
所以呢，他其实那时候就等待了五年的时间，然后一直到他成为这个替扫罗王拿盔甲的侍从。
And then he waited 10 more years until he was 25, and that's when King Saul made him the commanding general.
然后接着他又等待了十年，一直到他25岁的时候，那时候扫罗王就让他成为军队的这个总司令。
And he waited 5 more years as a, and then he was a refugee until he was 30 years old, hiding out in caves and avoiding the jealous king trying to kill him.
那接下来的五年呢，他就又一直等待，而且他那时候等待是在逃亡的情况下面等待，一直直到他30岁。在这个中间呢，他就是躲在山谷里面或山洞里面去逃避这个扫罗王对他的追杀。
In summary, David waited.
所以总和来说就是大卫等待。
But during the time of waiting, it did not go to waste.
但是他没有浪费他等待的这个时间。
Because David was faithful.
因为在当中呢，他是非常信实的。
See, as a shepherd, he wrote songs on the hillside and did what he could to help family business.
所以在当那时候到他当牧羊人的时候，他就会在山边写歌，然后并且去帮助他们家的家业。
As a soldier, he wrote songs for the in the king's courts and did all he could to help the nation prosper.
所以当他成为一个士兵的时候呢，他就会在王的殿里面写赞美的歌，然后呢，他尽情全力去帮助他的国家繁盛。
And as an exile, he wrote songs in caves and continued to support his family, his nation, and his God.
所以在当逃亡的时候呢，他就会躲在这些山洞里面，他还是继续写这些赞美的诗歌，并且用这个方法来支持他的家、他的国，还有他的神。
And what David didn't know, and he could not have known, was this, that while he was waiting, God was actually pruning and growing him to become the man that God would use to become the greatest king in Israel.
但是在当时大卫可能自己都不知道的是，当他在等待的时候，其实神不停的在他里面做工，然后帮助他 成为一个真的是属神的人，所以他并没有只是白白的在等待而已。
So if you are wondering right now at your home, how come God's promise in your life has not been fulfilled, I want you to know that God wants to do something in your life.
所以如果你现在待在家，然后一直怀疑神说，诶，神你给我的这些应许怎么一直都没有实现，那你要换个角度想，就是神其实现在正在你的心里做工。
One of the things that we need to learn that as we are waiting is we need to learn how to become a king.
所以我们要知道是当我们在等待的时候，其实我们也是在学习怎么做一个王。
We need to learn how to be royalty just like Jesus.
我们要学习我们如何像耶稣一样成为一个就是皇室的成员。
So how do we become that?
我们要怎么成为这样子的情况呢？
The answer is actually quite simple, but we need to truly embrace with our hearts.
其实这个方法很简单，但是我们是真心，我们必须要真心的来领受这件事情。
The truth is, you and I, we are already kings.
事实就是你跟我其实都已经是被拣选为王的人。
In 1 Peter 2:9 says, But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for his possession, so that you may proclaim the praises of the one who called you out of the darkness into his marvelous light.
因为在彼得前书第二章第九节就这么说，唯有你们是被拣选的族类，是有君尊的祭司，是圣洁的国度，是属神的子民，要叫你们宣扬那招你们出黑暗入奇妙光明者的美德。
So the first thing is to we need to realize is this, we have already been chosen to become royalty.
所以第一件我们必须要记得的事情就是我们其实已经被拣选成为皇室了。
This is not a title, this is not an identity that we say we want, it's because it has been given to us through Jesus Christ.
这并不是一个只是一个称谓而已，而是这件事情，这个身份其实是因为耶稣基督，所以让我们有这样子的身份。
And the second thing that we must learn as a king or a queen is this.
那第二件我们作为王或是作为一个王后的人，我们必须学到的事情是
We need to learn how to solve problems.
我们必须要学会怎么去解决问题。
In other words, when we see a problem, we need to...We don't want to shy away.
所以当我们看到一个问题发生的时候，我们不应该就去逃避而已。
Now, I'll be honest, this is much easier said than done.
那其实这句话呢，就是讲起来比做起来简单。
Because I know that, you know, when I see problems, sometimes it's so much easier for me to push away or try to let someone else who is more responsible to take over.
因为对我来说，有时候连我自己看到一个问题，其实把它推给别人或者是逃避这个问题都是一个比较简单的做法。
It's so much easier just to turn the other cheek or turn the eye and just walk away.
或者是说我就可以只是把头转开我就走开了，这是比较简单的一个做法。
See, for King David, as a 10-year-old, he was assigned to watch over the father's sheep in the field.
所以在大卫王十岁的时候，其实他是被他的爸爸派去看守羊群的。
And in 1 Samuel 17:35, when David faced the mountain lion, he says this. He says in 35, I go after it with a club to rescue lambs from its mouth. If the animal turns on me, I catch it by its jaws and club it to death.
所以那时候当大卫在看守羊群的时候看见这个山猫，他就会这么做，就是在撒母耳记上第17-35节就会说，我就追赶他，击打他，把羊羔从他口中救出来。他起来要害我，我就揪着他的胡子将他打死。
Now, as a shepherd boy, there's nobody out there in the middle of the field trying to teach him how to do that.
那作为一个牧羊人，在荒野之中，其实旁边没有其他人可以教导他怎么做这件事。
He didn't have a guide or a smartphone say, where he can Google say how to kill a mountain lion.
他也没有一只手机，然后他可以 Google 说我要怎么打死一只山猫。
But he had a heart of a leader. He had a heart of a king.
但是他有一个领袖的心跟一个作为王的心。
He wanted to protect his sheep.
他想要去保护他的羊群。
Because he wanted to serve his father well.
因为他想要好好的来服侍他的父亲。
So therefore he just took courage and God helped him.So that's why not only could he kill mountain lions, but also bears and other bigger animals.
所以他就有很勇敢的去面对这件事情。那在当中，神也帮助他，所以他不止打死了这些山猫，甚至在后来有这个熊或是更凶猛的动物出现，他都把他们一一都打跑了。
And throughout this process, he learned to grow and he learned not to be scared. He learned how to face giants in his life head on.
所以在这个过程之中呢，他就知道要，他就学会了要怎么去面对他生命里面的敌人。
So when he finally came for the time for him to face Goliath, he knew what it would take to conquer Goliath.
所以当他之后真的是碰到这个巨人哥利亚的时候呢，他就知道他要怎么来挑战并且打败这个敌人。
Because he told King Saul that I have a history in the wilderness with God. I know how to kill this giant that's in front of me. Because in the same way that God has helped me before in the wilderness, he will help me now.
所以那时候大卫就告诉扫罗说在我在荒野的时候，我有经验来对付这些大的野兽，因为神跟我同在。所以当我来面对这个巨人的时候，我也知道因为神与我同在，所以我可以来打败他。
So maybe there is a consistent problem that you are facing, whether it's at home, at work, or even at church. Maybe it is time for you to take up your courage and also to help out.
所以也许在你的家、你的教会或是你的工作上，你会发现有一个不停重复类似的状况发生，那这个时候也许就是你鼓起勇气来跟神一起来解决这个问题的时候。
Maybe now is the time for us to take ownership and to take pride in rebuilding the things or the people that's around us.
或者现在是一个我们重新来建造我们周围人的一个机会。
Because learning how to solve problems is the heart of a leader and a king.
因为解决问题其实是一个作为领袖或是作为王的人心里该有的一个特质。
So besides the truth and the fact that we are a chosen as king, and besides the fact we need to learn how to solve problems, there's also another thing we need to learn.
所以当我们刚刚讲到两个，第一个是知道我们是被拣选的，第二个是知道我们必须学会怎么去面对问题以后，有第三个课题我们必须要去学习。
We must learn how to follow.
我们必须要学会怎么去跟随。
In 1 Samuel 16:19-22, it reads, So Saul sent messengers to Jesse to say, Send me your son David, the shepherd. Jesse responded by sending David to Saul along with a young goat, a donkey loaded with bread, and a wineskin full of wine. So David went to Saul and began serving with him. Saul loved David very much, and David became his armor bearer. Then Saul sent word to Jesse, asking, "Please let David remain in my service, for I am very pleased with him."
所以撒母耳记上第十六到第十六章第十九到二十二节这么说。于是扫罗差遣使者去见耶西，说：“请你打发你放羊的儿子大卫到我这里来。”耶西就把几个饼和一皮带酒，并一只山羊羔都驮在驴上，交给他儿子大卫，送与扫罗。大卫到了扫罗那里，就侍立在扫罗面前。扫罗甚喜爱他，他就做了扫罗拿兵器的人。扫罗差遣人去见耶西，说：“求你容大卫侍立在我面前，因为他在我眼前蒙了恩。”
I believe that God has placed leaders in authority over us for a reason.
我相信神在我们当中建立一个领袖，其实是有一个原因的。
Now maybe the leader may not be the leader you expected, but God still has put him or her over you or me for a reason.
也许这个领袖呢跟我们预期当中的不太一样，但是神把他放在这个位置其实是有他的原因的。
And maybe this is the time when we come before God and recognize the leaders in your life.
也许现在就是一个时候，我们必须要来到神面前，并且去认识或者是愿意接受这些神放在我们生命中的领袖。
See, from age 15 to 20, you know, as an armor bearer, I'm sure there are things and plenty of things that that David learned from King Saul.
所以在大卫15到20岁的时候，他作为扫罗帮扫罗拿兵器的人，我想在他这个过程中，他一定从扫罗身上学到了很多作为王的行为跟事情。
He learned how to follow by simply being in the background.
他学习了要怎么待在国王的身后，不引人注目。
Perhaps holding his cape or coat.
也许是帮这个王拿衣服或者是他的东西。
Could be fetching things or running messages.
或者是他可能帮这个王跑腿拿东西，或者是传递消息。
Or he was able to sit in and listen as the King Saul had meetings with his advisors.
或者是说当扫罗跟他的谋士坐在一起开会制定计划的时候，也许大卫就是坐在这边，然后去观察并且去听他们的对话。
So maybe you're not the person in charge right now.
所以也许现在你并不是那个负责掌权的这个人。
But you think you should be in charge.
但是你可能觉得，诶，我应该是要当头的。
But God wants to teach you a lesson.
但是神想要教导你一个课题。
And which is number four, that God wants us to learn how to be humble.
也就是我们这边讲到的第四点，就是我们要学会谦卑。
See, Saul was an anointed leader and David knew it.
所以扫罗是一个被神恩膏的领袖，然后大卫其实也知道。
And one day, David, when he was running, he found Saul alone in a cave.Using the bathroom.
所以有一天呢，这个大卫在逃亡的路上，其实他就进到了一个山洞，然后刚好这个扫罗就在这个山洞里面上厕所。
And David had a chance to take his life, and he almost did. But at last minute, David decided that killing God's anointed was no way to get ahead in his life. So he refrained.
所以在那个时候，其实大卫是有一个机会可以把扫罗给杀死，然后他其实差点也就这么做。但是在最后一秒钟呢，他就突然决定说，其实杀了这个被神恩膏的人呢，并不是一个你应该做的事情，所以他最后就停，就住手了。
Then he did what you know many of us would take a lot of courage. You know, he humbled himself and he asked King Saul for forgiveness.
然后呢，接着他就做了一件，也许是在他生命里面最需要勇气的一件事情，就是他谦卑了他。在这个扫罗面前谦卑他自己，并且求这个扫罗来原谅他。
In First Samuel chapter 24:8 it says this. After that, David got up, went out to the cave, and called to Saul, "My lord, the king." When Saul looked behind him, David knelt low with his face on the ground and paid homage.
所以撒母耳记上24章第八节说，随后大卫也起来，从洞里出去。呼叫扫罗说：“我主，我王。”扫罗回头观看，大卫就屈身，脸伏在地下拜。
Someone said that the hardest person you will ever overcome is yourself.
有人曾经说过，就是我们生命当中最难克服的一个人，其实就是我们自己。
And David learned to humble himself.
所以大卫其实就学会了怎么自己，就自己谦卑。
And this is a lesson that every leader must learn.
所以这也是每一个领袖都该学会的一个课题。
So 5 years later, the day came, David was anointed as a king of the southern tribe of Israel, the tribe of Judah. He reigned there while he learned how to lead just one tribe. Until 7 years later, he was crowned as the king of all Israel and reigned in Jerusalem for 40 years.
所以在五年之后，大卫的这个时间终于到来了。所以呢，那时候大卫就被恩高成为以色列南部族群的一个王，就是犹大这个支派的王。然后他管理那地，一直到大概7年之后呢，他终于就正式的被就是被恩高成为以色列的王。然后接着他就在耶路撒冷掌权，然后统治耶路撒冷大概40年的时间。
The life lesson that we all need to learn is, even though David was anointed, he was called out at 10. It wasn't until much later, over 10 plus years, than when he officially became the king of a nation and stepped into his destiny. Until it took that long for God to make him a king in order for the promise to be fulfilled.
所以我们要学习的这个课题就是说，大卫尽管是在他10岁的时候他就被撒母耳恩高为王，但是一直是到20年之后他才是正式的成为了以色列的王。所以在这段时间里面呢，其实神都是在慢慢建造他，让他成为一个适合的王。
You know, the Bible calls us willing to be the head and not the tail.
所以其实圣经教导我们，我们应该要做一个头，而不是待在尾巴的地方。
But sometimes we try to use our own way in try to be the head, try to get ahead.
So
the head, yeah.
所以很多时候呢，我们其实是靠自己的力量，或是我们自己的方法，想要成为那个当头的人。
We try to move up the ladder, you know, in the corporate world, you know, with our own efforts.
所以我们在公司，在我们职场上，我们可能想要用我们自己的力量，不停的往上爬。
Now, while there's nothing wrong with working hard, but there is another, the more important lesson is we need to learn how to serve.
所以我们要一直努力工作其实并不是一件坏事，但是同时间我们也要学着怎么去服侍别人。
Being in a place of influence doesn't always mean we need to be the person, first person in charge.
所以我们有这个影响力不代表说我们一定是要成为这个当头的这个人。
David and Daniel and Joseph, they were both the second person in charge of a nation, but they had influence over the president at that time.
所以但尼尔跟这个约瑟夫，其实那时候他们虽然不是当王的那个人，但是他们对他们的国家在当时其实还是有很大的影响力。
And I believe that as we as our country is coming alive, as we're rebooting.God wants to make us kings and queens of this land.
所以当我们整个国家在逐步重启的时候，我相信神也是要培养我们成为一个王跟一个后。
I believe that better days are ahead of us because God's plan and promise will always prevail.
我相信呢，我们接下来的日子只会越来越好，因为这是神的应许。
You know, Ezra not only wrote, he didn't just write the first and second chronicles, he also wrote the book of Ezra and Nehemiah as well.
所以以斯拉呢，其实并不只是写历代记上下而已，他也写了以斯拉记还有尼希米记。
And when the people returned to the land, Ezra taught them the scripture on their own, and they came together in a place called synagogues to study God's word on the Sabbath.
所以当那时候以色列的人民回到了家乡的时候，这个以斯拉呢就教导他们说要自己来读这个经文，并且一起在会堂来聚集，在安息日的时候一起来研读神的话语。
You know, before Ezra, the Israelites, they only worship in the temple. So in other words, Ezra invented local synagogue or what you may call life groups or small groups in your homes.
所以在以斯拉之前呢，其实以色列人只会在这个 会就是殿堂里面一起的来敬拜，所以我们也可以说以斯拉因为他鼓励大家在当地的会堂呢自己聚集敬拜，所以其实他也就是发明我们生命小组或是小组的一个先知。
See, Ezra, he wasn't born when the Israelites were taken into captivity. He was a child when the exile took place. But he studied the people's history and he learned from it.
所以其实在以色列人被俘虏的时候，那时候以斯拉还没有出生。那在以色列人就是流放的时候，那时候以斯拉还是一个小孩。但是他去研读他族人们的历史，而且从里面学习到经验。
He remembered where his people had came from, and this is a do-over, and now we get the chance to do it.
所以他知道他有记起来说他的族人们是从什么样子的一个境地来到现在这个地方，所以他等于是有一个重新来过的一个机会。
He was determined to lead the people, in doing better by repeating the good and omitting the bad.
所以他也教导他的人民说，要从历史里面汲取这些好的事情，并且要重复做这些好的事情，那这些坏的东西要摒除掉。
And he always relied on God's promise and taught his people how to do the same.
然后他永远都是去仰赖神的应许，而且他教导他的子民也要这么做。
Church family, brothers and sisters, as we are restarting.
所以亲爱的弟兄姐妹，当我们今天生活要重新开始的时候，
Even before the lockdown fully lifts, I want us to remember what God has done for us in the past.
所以在警戒完全解除之前，我想要鼓励大家真的是想一想神过去为我们所做的事。
What are some of the mistakes that you feel like that God wants you to learn?
也许里面是一些可能过去犯下的错误，但是神想要让你从中学习。
Remember I said that the Israelites were under Babylonians until the king Persia.
所以刚刚我一开始有讲到，就是以色列人那时候被囚禁在巴比伦，直到波斯王来。
And in the same way, you know, I feel like God wants us to learn, you know, until the pandemic has fully been done away.
所以我有感动，就是神直到这个疫情完全结束之前，神其实是我们想要来学，神其实想要我们来学习一些事。
Because God is not done with us.And his church.
因为神对我们他的子民还有对这个教会想要做的事还没有结束。
And we need to continue to rely on God's promise.
所以我们要必须持续的来仰赖神给我们的应许。
And while we're waiting for God's promise to fulfill,
当我们在等待神完成他的来实现他的应许之前呢，
Let's not be anxious and remember that we have already been chosen, called to be kings and queens.
我们应该不要焦虑，并且牢牢记住，我们已经是被拣选成为王的人。
I want to learn how to solve problems that surround us. Ask God for wisdom, even for the things that you may not think you have an answer for.
所以面对到我们生命中的一些问题，也许我们没有答案，但是我们要记得来求靠神，让神来给我们解决问题的方法。
And we all must learn how to follow.
然后我们要学习怎么来跟随。
And this would help us develop a servant heart, the heart of humility.
所以这会让我们建有一个谦卑的心，然后一个作为仆人的心。
I believe these are the life lessons that God wants us to learn at this moment in time.
我相信这就是神在此时此刻希望我们学习到的课题。
So today as we end,
所以今天当我们在结束讲道的时候，
and we want to go into a time of communion.
我们想要来领圣餐。
We also want to remember what Christ has done on the cross for us.
我们也要来记起耶稣基督在十字架上为我们所做的事。
On the night when Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and he said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
所以在耶稣被背叛的那一天，他说，这是我跟你们立下的约。
In the same way, he took the cup of wine after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant between God and His people, an agreement confirmed by my blood. Do this as often as you drink it."、
sorry, what's the
passage? 11. 24.
Sorry.
It's okay. 所以24这个25。
OK， 所以哥林多前书第十一章第二十三章第二十三节，我来当日传给你们的，原是从主领受的，就是主耶稣被拜的那一夜，拿起饼来，祝谢了就拨开，说这是我的身体，为你们舍的，你们应当如此行，为的是纪念我。
So today, as you take your elements in your home，
所以今天当大家自己在家领圣餐的时候。
Let us remember.
让我们要记住
God's faithfulness and His promise.
神是信实的，然后神有给我们他的应许。
That our identity has already bought with a price, and we exchange our old identity with a royal identity.
耶稣基督已经为我们付出了代价，所以我们旧有的身份已经死去，并且我们现在是有了在神里面尊贵的身份。
And let God renew our mind, so when we see problems, we do not run away, but we face on.
所以让神来更新我们的心意，所以看到问题的时候，我们不会逃跑，而是依靠神来解决它。
So Father God, we thank you for today.
所以亲爱的天父，我们为今天来感谢你。
We thank you for your body that has been broken for us.
我们为了你你的身体为我们所舍，我们为了这件事情来大大的感谢你。
Restore our brokenness, so when we see things and people, we don't use broken lenses to look at them.
请你来医治我们的破碎，所以当我们看到破碎的人的时候，我们不会用自己的眼神来看他们。
And always help us remember that because of a covenant that we have with you.That your promise will always prevail.
然后请你让我们帮助我们来记住，因为跟你立下的约，所以你会永远来帮助我们。
We thank in the name of Jesus.
我们以上奉主耶稣基督的名祷告，感谢你。
Amen.
Amen.
That is it for this Sunday sermon.
所以这就是这个主日的信息。
Have a great Sunday, and we'll see you guys next week.
所以祝大家有个美好的周日，然后我们下周见。
You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I need before we